everybody, it's me, Taylor Studios, back again with another video. This time it's something a little bit different. This is going to be the first installment in something that I like to call the Figures of Sodor. Basically, this is going to be a series where I more or less talk about the people of Sodor and what they've done to contribute to the island just in general. And the first episode, logically, is going to be on the three Sir Topham hats. So, let us begin. Sir Topham Hatt I was born in 1880 in the town of Swindon and entered apprenticeship at Swindon Works in 1894 at the age of 14. Whilst he was there, he struck a friendship with William Arthur Stanier, and as stated, he once helped William Stanier out of a serious situation. He left Swindon in 1901 at the age of 21 and came to Sodor seeking employment from the A.W. Dry & Co. and became their engineer for the TKNELR under the recommendation, later aiding in the construction of the coffee pots. He married Lady Jane Brown, the daughter of Sir Handel Brown I, in 1910 and had two children, Barbara Jane Hatt in 1911 and Charles Topham Hatt in 1914. By 1914, the Northwestern Railway had been formed, and Sir Topham Hatt rose to general manager in 1923. Later managing director in 1936, and during nationalization in 1948, received his baronetcy on his appointment of chairman of the regional executive. Having already been presented to Her Majesty the Queen by Viscount Harwick, he gladly welcomed the Queen to Tidmouth in 1953. Sir Topham Hatt retired as controller of the railway in 1954, and later passed away at Wellsworth in 1956. Charles Topham Hatt was educated at Abbey School, Cronk, and from there was actually sent to Crewe as an engineering pupil under William Stanier. In 1937, he was sent overseas to help with railway service under the recommendation of William Stanier. He enlisted with the Royal Engineers during World War II, and in 1940, he was married to Amanda Crewery, I'm hoping I'm pronouncing that correctly, who had two children, Stephen Topham Hatt in 1941 and Bridget Amanda in 1943. After spending a period of time overseas, he came back to Sodor in 1952, where he was an engineering assistant at Croven's Gate Works. He became controller of the railway in 1954 after his father's retirement, and received his baronetcy after his father's passing in 1956. One of his first acts as controller was to make improvements to the new harbor at Natfort, as well as reopen the Arlesborough branch line, which had previously closed after the Mid-Soda Railway had closed due to lack of traffic. Charles Topham Hatt retired as controller in 1984, later passing away in 1997. Stephen Topham Hatt was born in 1941 and is clearly shown to have visited East Anglia with his family on holiday. He married Helen Margaret in 1970 and had three children, Richard Topham Hatt in 1972, Charles Nicholas in 1974, and Emily Helen in 1977. He became controller of the railway in 1984 and received his father's baronetcy after he passed away in 1997. With great skill, he actually welcomed the Prince of Wales to Sodor during the 50th anniversary of the railway series in 1995. Now, there is no confirmed date of when he retired, as it's stated that as of 2005, he is still controller of the railway at age 64. Now, this bit is purely a theory, but I like to imagine that he probably retired sometime after the events of the last book in 2011, and his son, Richard Topham Hatt, became the controller. And that's it, guys. That is all three Sir Topham Hatts basically explained. There is no information on Richard Topham Hatt, so we really can't say anything about him. If you guys enjoyed this video, then be sure to let me know down in the comments what historical Sodor figure you guys want me to talk about next. I'm leaning more towards maybe talking about the Scarloway Railway Controllers next, but we'll just have to wait and see. But until then, This has been Tailamp Studios saying goodbye and peace.